PI Reid in this segment, because we will be speaking with Stephen Roberts from Nomura about that in the next segment. I know that that inflation read did come in as a bit of a surprise, but Julia, I'm talking about the market performance, even the fact that we saw a little bit of momentum across Asian markets as well today, considering we are still awaiting this European Leaders Summit tonight.
The two best markets around the region today were the Australian market and the Shanghai Composite. And if you have a look at the drivers of both of them, it was expectations around interest rates. In both countries, we have seen interest rates quite high. In China, they've been climbing, and in Australia, we've seen them on hold for a while. So if we have a look at the Australian share market, this is the intraday graph of the Australian market today. And you can see that the turning point came when those inflation numbers were released. We went from having quite a weak session in the morning to a strong session in the afternoon, where we were in the black. The retailers, a key beneficiary of this, because if we do see interest rates fall, it does mean that consumers should have more to spend in their pockets. It's also a positive for companies which are trying to fund their growth through debt, and most companies do that. And also, if we have a look at competing products, cash becomes a less attractive investment here in Australia. Also, if we have a look at the Shanghai Composite, we've seen some comments coming through from the Premier over there. So the last 3 days have been positive ones. Also on expectations that in China, that we've seen an end to that tightening of monetary policy and interest rates going up there. So altogether, a positive for the Australian market and for China. But as you mentioned, Nadine, it's all about the Eurozone tonight. We have seen that meeting of our Eurozone finance ministers being cancelled. So I guess the market doesn't have too optimistic hopes going into the European session tonight, but all eyes on a European Union financial stability plan, and the market will be watching to see what comes out of that.
News that we got today from Fortescue Metals. It's looking to raise capital, doing so in the U.S. markets. Julia, it was interesting moves in Fortescue's share price today as well, because initially it was trading lower. We also had news that the price of iron ore continues to retreat as much as 7% today. But by the end of the session, we saw Fortescue shares up by 1.5%. So what is that reflecting? Is it reflecting, you know, this issue that we saw in the United States, or where do you see it?
This is all about funding. Fortescue had to come up with about $8.4 billion worth of funding to be able to pay for its expansion in the Pilbara region. And there was only $1.5 billion of that left. And it does look like it's managed this through the bond issue. So it has gone back to the U.S. market. Remember earlier on in the year that Fortescue did try to go to the U.S. markets for about $1 billion worth of funding through the bond markets. And it wasn't able to find it on commercial terms. So there had been a little bit of worry given the volatility that we are seeing in markets, the concerns about Europe, about whether or not they'd be able to get the amount they wanted. But it looks like they managed to get $1.5 billion away at 8.25%. That means the funding for the ramp-up of their expansion in the Pilbara region now in place. So they are trying to ramp up to 95 million tonnes per annum by September 2012, and that's through Chichester, and then, of course, up to 155 million tonnes per annum by around about 2013 through their Solomon expansion. So altogether, positive news for Fortescue. And Nadine, as you mentioned, that's despite that huge tumble that we've seen in iron ore prices. If we have a look at the Platts index, down by 7.2% overnight. That's the biggest fall that we've seen since this index started back in 2008, November 2008, and in fact iron ore prices off by around about 30% since the start of September. So a lot of concern about the demand of iron ore going forward. We know that iron ore demand is quite strong at the moment, but we have seen a softening in terms of China's property market, and that's causing a lot of concern about iron ore demand. And if we have a look at what iron ore is used for, it's used in steel production, and steel production really driven by the construction markets in the US and China. And of course, it's the concerns around China at the moment which is driving prices.
Are you getting the feeling out there that this market is just looking for some good news, looking for a time and a chance to move forward and to rally?
I think a lot of traders are waiting on the sideline to see what happens out of Europe tonight. So that's going to be a key hurdle for the market. Don't forget the G20 meeting next week on the 2nd and the 3rd of November. So that's going to be a key as well. If we do see an interest rate cut here in Australia, that would be a positive for our stocks here. It would be a positive for our companies in terms of growth, and positive for especially the consumer sector. So that's going to be watched very closely. Mm-hmm. The Interbank futures now pricing in an 89% chance of an interest rate cut on Melbourne Cup Day. So that's going to be huge. And as Chris did mention, the numbers coming out of the US have surprised on the upside. So those third quarter GDP numbers expected to be stronger than most investment houses have them at the moment. So altogether, a positive from the US. The big question mark is over Europe and the banking system there, and the market's going to be watching that closely tonight. Well,